I'm here with Dan Kerr, a volunteer for flight operations. Dan, can you tell us a little about your job here?
Yeah, basically flight operations are, we're in charge of the airplanes that we have here on display at the museum. And it's our responsibility to keep them in what would be considered an airworthy condition, even though they're missing the engines and the weapon systems and a lot of the electronics. We still want to maintain the appearance of the aircraft and the integrity of them because they're of historic value and they were also very expensive, and we're real proud to have them here at the museum on display.
You were at Northrop Grumman when they started moving these planes, weren't you? Can you show us and tell us a little bit about the move?
Yes, ma'am, I'd be happy to. Yeah, it's always exciting when you have aircraft of any type being towed down the street. Although the actual hookup of the aircraft didn't take that long, they actually started the move from the Northrop Grumman parking lot at about 4 a.m. And the larger tow truck with its longer extender was able to hook underneath the nose of the F-14 Tomcat. That's usually a problem with most ground vehicles because of the fact that the nose is so low to the ground with the radome, which is the radar dome assembly, is the nose of the airplane, houses the radar dish. When we left Hawthorne Airport in late 2006, Northrop Grumman was gracious enough to offer us a place to store our aircraft. And so we were able to keep them in the area. And then as soon as we opened and had a space available in our new facility in Torrance, that's what prompted the towing of the YF-17 Cobra and the F-14 Tomcat down to our new home at Zamperini Field. And the F-14 normally has a weight of approximately 43,000 pounds, but because both of the TF-30 turbofan engines have been removed, it reduced the weight to 20,000 pounds. But that's still quite a substantial amount for an aircraft to be towed by a single point, which is the nose gear. In the YF-17 Cobra, that is the Northrop aircraft, has also had the engines removed. So its weight without the engines is approximately 10,000 pounds. Van Lingen Towing provided two large tow trucks and three of their smaller trucks. And the City of Torrance provided two motor officers and two cars for traffic control, and then also as follow-along vehicles down to the aircraft's new home in Torrance. And as they left the gate, I'm sure that they were some of the most unique vehicles that the gate guard had checked out of the Northrop lot in several years. As both aircraft were lined up on the street and all of the vehicles got in convoy, you can see through the engine inlet of the F-14 Tomcat that there is no jet turbine in the aircraft any longer. The convoy proceeded on Imperial Highway with the F-14 in the lead, and when they reached the bridge at the 405 freeway, they determined that the clearance was going to be too close for the vertical stabilizers to clear the bridge. So the tow truck that was hooked up to the YF-17 was able to do a U-turn and then proceed down La Cienega. But because of the size of the F-14 and that it was being towed by the larger truck, they had to unhook the tow bar, switch to a smaller truck, and after several maneuvers, they were able to turn the aircraft around and then have it also proceed down La Cienega. One of the unique things of towing an aircraft, unlike towing a boat or a travel trailer, is the fact that between you and the tow bar, you have a pivoting wheel, which is the nose wheel. And it makes for some difficult maneuvering of the vehicle, even in forward or when you're making turns. It always gets your adrenaline flowing when you look in your rearview mirror and see a Torrance police unit with its red lights flashing behind you, but then to realize that there are four police vehicles, two motor officers, two cars, four tow trucks, and then two jet fighters coming past you as you are on Hawthorne Boulevard heading towards the Torrance Airport. It's an exciting sight, and it would definitely wake you up early in the morning. The move proceeded through different areas and down until it came to Madrona, And on Madrona Street, you can see how close the clearances were between the aircraft and some of the light fixtures that were along the street. And there's the YF-17. It's being towed past one of the light fixtures. You could see how close the clearance was. The tow truck operators had to actually weave back and forth to get the wingtips to make clearance between that and the light stands as they went down the street. Even with the wings in the folded position on the F-14 Tomcat, its widest point was still approximately 35 feet, and it made for a tight fit on some of the areas down Madrona and some of the other streets in Torrance as the convoy made its way toward Torrance Airport. The aircraft are now proceeding down Hawthorne Boulevard and Delamo Mall, and you can see in the background how it's becoming daylight. They wanted to try and get the move done within an hour and a half to 2 hours, but circumstances that were, it did not quite make it in that time frame. The move actually took such a long period of time, longer than expected, that the Torrance Police Department had to switch from the midnight watch to the AM watch. So more than just four officers were able to get in on the move. They had a total of eight different officers, two motor and two patrol vehicles. And this is proceeding down Airport to the east towards the gate that the aircraft will eventually be brought in to down by the East T hangars. You can see how the motor officer is weaving back and forth, trying to give an indication to the tow truck operator of the tight clearance and the operation that they need to do to get the aircraft down the street in such tight quarters. The final destination of the aircraft was reached after approximately 4.5 hours of maneuvering through the city streets, where it was pulled into the large gate that is adjacent to Torrance Airport on the east end of the airfield. Yeah. The first aircraft that was brought in through the gate was the F-14 Tomcat, and it was preceded shortly after there by the YF-17 Northrop Cobra. As the aircraft were brought into Torrance Airport, they switched to the smaller tow truck so they could facilitate the 90-degree turn that was required to get the aircraft in through the gate. People watching the waves and stuff. And this is a YF-17 making the 90-degree turn from Airport Drive into the gate, and it has the observers on both wings, making sure the clearance is enough for the aircraft to fit through the gate. The aircraft paused temporarily by the T-hangars to get clearance from ground control before proceeding westerly along the main taxiway to be parked on the end of the Western Museum of Flight's hangar, just to the west of the General Aviation Center. To see both aircraft taxiing westbound on taxiway Alpha was a wonderful sight, because we've been waiting to get them on display here for over a year. As the aircraft made their final turn to their parking space at the end of the museum, they drew quite a crowd from the General Aviation Center and other airport businesses in the area. People stopped to take pictures and ask about the airplanes.